What's up, everybody? So let's talk about Tamar Braxton, Krishan Rock, and James Wright Chanel yet again. So I did make a video yesterday, and in the video, I put a snippet of the response from Tamar in that video, and it was just a snippet. It was not the whole thing or whatnot. And so she was basically addressing the situation. She confirmed that Krishan did indeed hit James in the face. And she also confirmed that she did not ask Krishan to perform. She just invited her onto the stage. And so there's been a lot of back and forth since this has happened. So Carlissa has responded, Blueface Mama, oh my God. Then Tommy from Love and Hip Hop. And then Tamar is responding to this as well. And James Wright Chanel responded to as well. So let's watch the video of Tamar in its entirety.
Hey everybody, I look crazy. Let me take this off. Not that my headband looks any better, but I wasn't going to say anything out of respect for James and his trauma and what happened to him. And when I say what happened to him, he got assaulted at my show. And it was by Krishan, but there was a lot of events that I believe were misconstrued. And so while I'm not going to set out the time and clear every little thing up for everyone, I want you to know the reason why I decided to say something. Number one, I care about my team. They're all of my friends. And we put this all together for the fans. I'm not a clout chaser. I don't need that. Like, my circle is this small, you know. I don't have to sell tickets for, you know, like, oh, I need to sell tickets. Let me do this, that, other. This show has been sold out for a month. I didn't have an opening act. I knew I didn't need an opening act because I knew my sister was coming in the middle of the show. And you know, when you're in different cities, you invite different people. And Krishan was definitely someone that I invited, someone that I actually, you know, looked at from afar as like a younger sister. She's from Baltimore. I knew that she was rowdy, you know. I didn't judge her because of that. You know, I felt for her on so many occasions, and I just felt like, oh, this was somebody I wanted to meet, to, you know, possibly take under my wing, because, you know, everybody knows that I don't have the best past. I'm sorry, I have a filter. I washed my face. I look crazy. Okay. You know, and in my journey of being a better person, I wanted people to, you know, accept me for the new person that I was. And the only way that they could do that is if I was given an opportunity. And so that's really all it was. I didn't call her and be like, oh, come on and perform at my show. I already knew Tony was planning to perform here at this LA show. She had sent me her number a while ago on a DM, and I reached out to her. Like I said before, like we all have, you know, Krishan is like a little sister to all of us watching her, and then watch her make mistakes. We want to help. We want to help. And this is what this Love and War tour has been about. You know, I have called several girls that I didn't know Drew Sidora. I didn't know Tiffany Evans. I didn't know any of them, really. The only person that I knew was Nivea, you know. But I wanted this tour to be about, you know, second chances and, you know, giving new opportunities. And I didn't call Krishan to open up for me. But when she was in my dressing room, we do a twerk off portion, right? And I was like, oh, it'd be cool if the DJ played as a vibe and you came out and did a vibe like the people, you know, your Baltimore sisters. And that's really what I was thinking. Everyone else get compensated for coming on my show and opening up for me. I try to always do the right thing by people. And there's a contract. We're professional. I'm a real touring company. And that wasn't the case. I think that there was a misunderstanding. During the part of the twerk off, I am backstage changing clothes. And everybody that's come to a Tay Marcia show know that we don't have any violence. No one has ever fought at my concerts. We laugh, we cry. People have passed out, you know, due to, you know, being, you know, inebriated or, you know, just excited at being at a concert. But this is a safe, loving, healing place. And I don't know. I have to apologize to my team if my silence have made you all feel like I have not been supportive to you. And I also want to acknowledge Krishan. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for coming. You know, I didn't want any of this to happen. I actually thought that we, you know, could really be, you know, good friends and have, you know, I could be a big sister, you know, to you. And that was my only objective of you coming. I had no other plans. I didn't want to set you up. I didn't tell nobody not to play your music. I just want everybody to come and have a good time. And that is really the spirit of it all. But I have to acknowledge my team because my team has been traumatized. And especially James. He was assaulted and he was hurt. And I just feel like I can't make nobody happy. And I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I really wish you would have hit me instead of him. You know, I'm just so sorry it happened to you. And I'm sorry, Krishan, if you felt that, you know, anybody, any of us wanted to use you for hype. No one... I'm not even going to address that because it's ridiculous. I know that when people come into this industry and, you know, they get a certain amount of stardom or fame, they feel like, oh, what does this person want with me? What does this person want with me? And there are some genuine people. But I'm doing this video for my staff and for my team who believed in me and who has helped supported me, Troy especially. You know, who has been the most passionate about this. And he should have, you know. He's my partner and, you know, watching, you know, someone so close to us, you know, get so violated is traumatizing. And I really honestly, truly wish none of this happened. We are still doing part two. Like I said before, we don't fight at our concerts. Everybody who has gone has had a lovely, fun family setting and time. And I don't know. It's just unfortunate. And let me just tell you how amazing James is. Like, no matter how he's feeling, he told me today, he was like, you know, when she hit me, I just feel like I just wanted to hug her. She'd be like, I'm just really sorry that it all happened, and I don't know, I just felt like on behalf of my team, being the leader, sometimes you don't know, you know, what role to take, and I just want everybody to know, I just want everybody to know that I'm sorry, and I don't know. But I won't be speaking about this anymore. This has really hit us hard, you know, and it really hit us all hard. No one deserved it, you know, and no one wanted to hurt anybody, and no one wanted to disrespect anybody, and nobody wanted to set anybody up. We just wanted to have a good time. I love you guys. And I'll see you in a few weeks. I'm sorry, James. You're an amazing person. This should have never happened. And I'm also sorry, Krishan, that you feel like in your life that everybody is out to get you. That must be a horrible feeling. That's a horrible feeling. I don't know. I'll see you guys in a couple weeks. I love you.
Okay, so y'all saw the video of Tamar, and why it took Tamar this long to respond is beyond me. Like, she should have really responded when it happened right then and there. I don't know if she is trying to protect Krishan, or I don't know what it was, but for the fact that she basically thanked Krishan for coming out and then apologizing. Like, girl, why are you apologizing to Krishan? Like, are you afraid of Krishan or what? I mean, I know that Krishan probably could drag you and beat you, but listen, this girl literally, and it was because of you, Tamar. Now, you got to take some accountability too as well. But this girl was at your concert and you invited her onto your stage. You did not have to do all that. You know how she is. You even said it yourself that she was rowdy. Now, the fact that you invited her onto the stage is crazy to me. So you definitely need to take accountability for that. But I don't know if Tamar is trying to protect Krishan because she knows Krishan is on probation, or she just feels sorry for the girl. I don't know what it is, but I really think that Tamar should have came out earlier and spoke on this situation, because James is part of your staff, right? And so they also were saying that her good friend LaTroy either blocked Tamar or he unfollowed Tamar or whatever, because they were thinking that Tamar had blocked him, but I don't think so. I think he probably blocked her because he was upset that she had not spoken out, because he did say, listen, if you're no one else is going to speak up for me, I'm going to speak up for me, right? And so after Tamar posted this video, Carlissa, which is Blueface's mother, Lord have mercy, this lady is slick funny for real though. I'm not gonna lie, she's messy, but she's a little funny too as well. So check out this video.
Now, this is no disrespect, because I love the Braxtons and I respect them. The baby, she said she wish she would have hit her instead of him. Girl, no you don't. She done knocked the rest of that nose clean the fuck off.
Carlissa is highly messy, right? And so after she posted that, Tamar responded and said this: I have never met none of their people. Please leave me alone. I'm only here because my brother James got hit in the face for being nice to a guest. He left with a chipped tooth, gum damage, and a busted nose and a concussion. However, I still pray for those who need help. I come in love. God bless everyone. And as y'all can see, Krishan did some damage to James, and she definitely needs to be held accountable for this. And before y'all say, well, she has a baby, she knew she had a baby before she hit this man. Krishan is unhinged. And when she gets upset, she feels like she can hit any and everybody. Now, she has not met the right person yet, because if she had met the right person, she probably would have been dealt with by now, right? But I do think she needs to be held accountable, and she is on probation. So if James pressed charges, which I believe he probably have already, she will be violating her probation and she probably be sent to jail. And she does need to be held accountable because she needs to learn a lesson. She has not learned a lesson. And these Christianians that be windmilling for her don't want to hold her accountable, and she don't even want to hold herself accountable either. But anyway, Tommy from Love and Hip Hop, honey, she had to say something too as well. I just wonder, would this one not all this rest, But if she wasn't there, would this one have been this viral? Remember the question when you respond. Now, baby, Tommy, you need to honey. Basically, Tommy was saying was, if she had not invited Krishan up, would this have gone viral? So that's basically what Tommy was saying. And so after Tommy made that comment, then Tamar responded by saying this. And before someone take my phone, if you own that white stuff and your name starts with a T and you never even sold out a bag of blow pops, stay silent. God bless y'all. Let me and my team heal from this trauma in peace. And so, of course, Tommy had to respond, and this is what she posted. She posted a crying emoji. So basically, she's just laughing at Tamar because, honey, you are comical at this point. She also went on to say, nothing a bitch say apply to me, so I don't be moved at all. And she also said, gotta address me for it to hit Muppet Baby. Child, a whole old mess. And then Tamar responded by saying this. So now y'all want me to address out of work reality stars? Never. Me and my Muppet employed ass will keep you on the list if needed. A non-fighting cokehead for $2,500 an episode for one of these shows of mine I'm casting for. We not the same. Go sell some ass for your next hits. I'm finna come with my next hits. Ooh, child. Now, Tamar, if you would have put all the energy into blasting Krishan like how you did Tommy, girl, we would be like, okay, you doing something then, right? And so after that, James made a video as well. He went live at the dentist's office.
I just want y'all to stop thinking that everybody's lying. Yes, this happened to me, and everybody keeps asking, what's the reason? This happened to me for no reason. I was attacked for no reason. And they keep telling me don't get on live, but no. Like, all the assumptions and how people feel and what people think they know, I am at the dentist right now. I have to get my teeth fixed. My teeth have to be fixed, and that's what's happening right now. So don't get online saying what didn't happen, it didn't happen. And no, I'm not going to show my face. My face is beat. If you guys see my face, you could be pissed off. My face is, it's toe up. So right now, I have to get teeth fixed that someone damaged. I'm not going to show my face, but I will show that I'm at the dentist right now. Getting my teeth fixed. The anger or whatever the issue was, wasn't towards me. So that's why I'm saying I was attacked for no reason. Yes, I know I don't owe anyone anything, but enough with the blaming everybody else but the person that did this. I'm out of the hospital. Now I'm at the dentist, Nikki. I have to get teeth fixed. My teeth are jacked up. They're saying, oh, nothing happened. Oh, he's a clout chaser. I don't need nobody's clout, and I don't want clout from a negative source. I don't do negative, and negative is not on my page. I don't know why me, but I'm going to tell y'all this before I get off of here, because I'm getting emotional. But I asked God, I said, why did this happen to me? And God said, it wasn't about you. He said, but I had to use you. He said, I had to use you. And when he said, I had to use you, all I could do was think of the story of Job. And I began to praise God in the midst of what was going on.
Okay, so y'all saw that video from James. And a lot of people were like, okay, if she indeed hit you, which Tamar confirmed that he was indeed hit, then why don't you show your face? And I just feel like he really doesn't have to show his face if he does not want to at this point, right? And we can all agree that Krishan is unhinged, and we've seen her hit people when she gets upset. So I can definitely 100% believe that she hit James in the face. I can believe that. Now, if he does not want to show his face right now, he does not have to. That does not mean that he is lying because he's not showing his face. He does not want to. He may not want to be talked about or ridiculed from Krishan's fans. I've had Christianians in my comment section windmilling for this girl, telling me that I was a hater. So I can just imagine if he posted his face, how they would do to him. So, y'all, this whole little situation is a mess. And Tamar also stated this: I'm tired, y'all. I don't know about this part two tour. We are all hurting. And if I didn't say anything, I'm wrong. I said something and I'm lying. I'm tired. Meanwhile, James is at the dentist getting new teeth. Y'all leave me alone. I was only trying to show Krishan Rock love. I still think she needs hugs and real people. No, Krishan needs to get a mental evaluation. She needs to heal her unresolved trauma. And she needs to stop putting her hands on people. That's what she needs to do. She needs to be held accountable. So, y'all, honey, this video was long. But anyway, so what are y'all whole thoughts about this situation with Tamar, Krishan, and James? Y'all know what y'all gotta do. Comment down below. Let me know your thoughts. If you're new to my channel, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Share this video. Like this video. And y'all know what y'all gotta do. Stay tuned for the next video. Bye.